Hello guys, today new unique chemical reactions are waiting for you. I'm sure you haven't seen any of these before, because the chemical reagent of this episode is very rare and expensive. Today I'm going to show you a cool chemical reaction spec with rhenium heptoxide. Rhenium heptoxide is the oxide of one of the rarest metals called rhenium. This compound is rhombic crystals of lemon yellow color. This is a volatile solid matter that is easy to deliquesce in the air. It's very rare and expensive chemical reagent. Sigma Aldrich sells it for about $100 per gram. My sample in a sealed glass ampoule contains 10 grams of pure rhenium 7 oxide. Rhenium heptoxide crystals have the properties that are typical of the molecular ones: low stability of crystal lattice and low melting and boiling points. When heated to 300 degrees Celsius, rhenium heptoxide sublimates and settles down on colder tubes' walls. Look how beautifully rhenium heptoxide is crystallizing. Unlike its group neighbor, manganese 7 oxide, rhenium 7 oxide is not a strong oxidizer. One of the few metals that are oxidized is bromine from hydrobromic acid. As strange as it is, I didn't happen to have hydrobromic acid, so I had to get it. And how do true chemists get their hydrogen bromide? Exactly, hydrolysis of boron tribromide. Boron tribromide is a fuming liquid compound. It's decomposed by water and forms hydrogen bromide and boric acid. Let's add some crystals of rhenium 7 oxide into hydrogen bromide solution. The reaction takes place in a boiling solution. Thank you. Rhenium 7 oxide reacts with hydrogen sulfide instantly at room temperature, forming black rhenium sulfide. Burned down in air, rhenium sulfide forms rhenium trioxide and white smoke that consists of rhenium 7 oxide particles. In this reaction, we'll get rhenium trioxide by decomposing the solvate with a rhenium 7 oxide and dioxan. One can also get it by decomposing rhenium 7 oxide solvates with such matters as ethyl alcohol, acetyl acetone, pyridine, tetrahydrofurane, etc. Rhenium trioxide, it is a red solid with a metallic luster, which resembles copper in appearance. It is the only stable trioxide of the group 7. For maximum yield, we are heating the precipitation we got in oxygen flow. Here you may also see front rhenium 7 oxide that we already know well. Blue stain that appears occasionally is probably a matter of unstable mixed rhenium 7 oxide and rhenium trioxide, type oxide forming during the process. Rhenium trioxide reacts with nitric acid to form nitrogen dioxide. Being dissolved in water, rhenium heptoxide forms a strong monobasic perrhenic acid. Thus, formed perrhenic acid dissolves metallic magnesium to form magnesium perrhenate and hydrogen. If we add hydrogen hydrate to perrhenic acid, dark brown, almost black rhenium dioxide can be obtained. One of the first suggested qualitative reaction for rhenium, whether it's perrhenate ions or rhenium ions, was the interaction of tiocyanate ions with tintochloride and a hydrochloric acid solution containing any compounds of rhenium. As a result, the color changes from yellow to orange. The complex that is formed in this reaction is extracted with diethyl ether. It is used in analytical chemistry of rhenium. At the beginning of the video you saw rhenium heptoxide melting and sublimation, but it sublimes without melting in oxygen flow, forming very very thin rhombic crystals. It looks amazing. Hi Dexterios, I read a comment where you suggest a mixture for extra exotic termite consisting of rhenium heptoxide and hafnium. I did it and I will share the result of this experiment in the next video. That's why subscribe to the channel to make sure you don't miss it. See you there!